Illustrator is like Photoshop, but instead of pixels, you work with mathematical functions. Please don't click off the video. Create a new document. I don't care which preset you choose. Welcome to the workspace. If you open up the window tab, I recommend you click on these things and drag everything to a convenient place. You will need them. Zoom in and out with Alt Scroll Wheel. This is also the superior way of moving around instead of panning, which is done by holding down space and dragging. Make a shape. Press M for a rectangle or L for a circle. Right click on this thing here for more shapes, drag and release, or click once for more control over the size. And look at that! Press V or click on this thing up here for your normal cursor. You can select, move, scale and rotate objects with it. You can hold shift while creating or transforming stuff to keep them all nice and proportional. Holding alt while doing that will make them all symmetrical. If you hold on both at the same time, the stock market will collapse. I want to make a triangle. Choose the polygon tool, drag it a bit and change the number of edges with your up and down keys. You can make triangles, stop sign shapes, all that kind of stuff. Hold down shift for best effect. I want to make the NATO star. Choose the star tool and do the same thing. Speaking of NATO, look at this. And remember, flat art makes you a bad person. While using the star tool, you can hold down control to change how sharp it ends up. Useful for making really fat stars. If you like playing around with Bezier curves, you can use the pen tool with P to create a plethora of other objects. If you don't like Bezier curves, go play the Bezier game for a bit. For even more shapes like trapezoids and isosceles triangles, you can press A for the direct selection tool and move the certain points an object has. You can even add more points or delete them by pressing equal and minus. You can transform shapes in other ways besides just scaling, moving and rotating them. If you right click on something and then go to transform, you'll see that you can choose reflect to mirror objects or shear. If the shear panel is way too complicated for you, go to window, toolbar, advanced toolbar. This will give you a bunch of new tools, one of which is shear, found under the scale tool. This is how I did the SG logo, hey! Copy and pasting, Ctrl C and Ctrl V. You can actually do it more quickly by holding down alt and dragging a shape. If you Ctrl C something, then while you're about to hit Ctrl V, you also press on shift. You will copy it right on top of the first object, useful for making concentric circles. You'll notice that some shapes are above others. You can change that by selecting things and pressing alt square brackets. They will move your shape up and down by one position. If you want to send a shape to the absolute front or back, press shift alt square brackets. Let's color our shapes. Things in Illustrator have a fill and a stroke. The fill is the inside of the shape, and the stroke is the line that goes along the shape. You can change how bold the stroke is from here or here. Select your shape, make sure you have the big square on the left in front, and choose a color from swatches or the color wheel. You just colored the fill of the shape. Click on the hollow square on the right or just press X and do the same thing. You colored the stroke. You can also make them transparent if you want a very thin donut or a borderless circle. Or nothing. There's also gradients and patterns which you can make yourself or just get from stock Illustrator. Documents come in two different color modes. CMYK, which stands for cyan, magenta, yellow and black, is the one you use if your artwork will end up printed somewhere in the real world. For art that is digital only, use RGB, which has far more vibrant colors. You can change them from file document color mode. If your colors still look whack, use an online color scheme generator. They're pretty nice. Strokes are cool, not really, but I want to turn them into an object. Select your thing, look up, go to object, path, outline, stroke. I want to get sued. Make three circles, open up the pathfinder panel. With those selected, click on unite and bam, it's all one shape. Very useful stuff. This is where you can also use minus front to cut away from shapes. Make sure the shape you're cutting is below the shape you're making the cut with. Or use stuff like divide to make every intersection of the selected shapes into their own shape. Useful for sunglasses. Note that after you do that, they will become grouped. Group objects with Ctrl G and ungroup them by right clicking and selecting ungroup. This is helpful when you have a lot of little things and want to manipulate them at the same time. Much like a Discord moderator, layers are also a thing. A 2-year-old can understand them. Let's move on. I have a bunch of things, but I can't get them to align. Go to the align panel like a normal person. You can either align them around one axis or multiple. The icons explain themselves. I want to write stuff. Text is easy. Press T and drag around the text box. Simply clicking will also do the job, but it's harder to work with in my opinion. You can turn it into an object by right clicking the text box and choosing create outlines. Note that you won't be able to write in it after that. because it won't be a text box. You can also write on lines by holding down Alt and clicking on a path. Useful if you're making a patch. But how do I make this not be upside down? Look up, go to type, type on a path, options, and click flip. Look at it go. Speaking of writing, you can make a magazine or a book using artboards, which are just other pages. Make 50 of them. When you run out of space, rearrange them with this thing here. If you wanna change the shape of an artboard, click on it and press Shift O. If you want your zine to have a cool title with a drop shadow, there are two methods I know of that are both extremely overly complicated for what they do. So just do it in Photoshop. If you really wanna do it in Illustrator, open up the appearance panel. From window, add a new fill. Make it pink or something. Click on the original fill. Click on that FX thing. Choose distort and transform. Then transform. This thing pops up. Put a lot of copies down there. Then adjust the numbers to your liking, so you can choose what direction it goes to. Who came up with this shit? Why can it not be like 3 clicks? I want to make the Obama poster. This is where you have to convert a raster image into vector. Drop one in, go to image trace, choose a setting. Wait a few hours and hope this doesn't break your $50 computer. And then voila. You can then click expand to turn everything into shapes. Different options are good for different things. For example, if you have line art which you drew in another program, silhouette is going to work best. Now that we have a piece of contemporary art, let's export it in file export. Export for screens will let you save art by exporting each artboard independently, and nothing but the artboards. Export as will export all of your art, but it will ignore the shape of the artboards. Lastly, export selection does as it says. Choose PNG because it's the superior option, and there you have it, a masterpiece. If everything you make kinda sucks, you can slowly learn what looks good by plagiarism. Take pictures of random images that aren't bad looking and recreate them. Change it a bit. Now it's your art. Do this a few more times until you can come up with nice stuff yourself. Just don't sell stuff you stole. This has been the Illustrator tutorial. There are some features I skipped over because I don't find them useful. If you don't understand something, comment and I'll get to you. Or just Google it. Cheers for watching.